That I need to cut this at to be the corner end piece. And to give me the length that I'm gonna need for the actual side on the end, because it's gonna basically be like a box, or like it sits down like a popsicle stick's depth under the two balconies, with like the outer edge matched, and then it like sinks in so that there it can be filled up with plants and stuff. And then there's these two pieces that are to go around. Where is it? This edge part. Sorry, this edge part go around the wooden post and then come off each side on the front, two of them, and then on the sides, two of them, to hold up the deck portion. So it'll be about 5 popsicle sticks wide in each dimension. I am going to be using about 50 popsicle sticks. Probably a few more than that if you also count the sheds. And I did go through and make sure that I had the 50 popsicle sticks and the ones for the shed in the different color, and some of the other ones set aside. Cat hair for various stuff. More cat hair. And wherever I put it, one more thing to show you, and this is something I'll probably actually Dremel on stream. I have these big popsicle sticks here, one of which it looks like I was planning on using for my the door. I think I dropped one of them. Anyways, there's a door for the shed on one of them mapped out that you'll probably see. I'm gonna be Dremeling a little moon and a star vent in it. It's probably gonna actually be like a garden shed, but I didn't want it to like not look like an outhouse, just because I thought it would add more details to have the little door with the cutouts and stuff. I always thought those looked cute, you know, as cute as like a bathroom can look, I guess. So there's also, so this is gonna be shingled much like this in slices of wood, and this sticks that I found to act as the logs here, they're the width that they are, there's actually gonna be like 5 to 7 of them, which is good because I wanted it to look like a tall stack of logs, right? But I need a diameter bigger than that to make the shingles for the roof, which I have, but outside and probably frozen. So I need some of my larger branches to defrost before I can do the rest of that. I do need more potting soil. I think I mentioned that for the peas. I was hoping this would take at least an hour so that I could see if my bot kicks in. I have it, I do have it set to only go on after a certain amount, like number of lines of text, and only once an hour. So, what else do I want to update you about? Normally, I would make notes and not need them, but this time I didn't make notes and probably should have them, because my brain used up all of the thinking juice. About like really was mentally hyperactive, kind of manic recently, and just like nosedived into like relatively simple as far as the program is concerned, but like kind of complex questions of logic, and have just been like playing these sort of very straightforward logic, just hardcore logic games for like days now, and my brain is just like, where'd the thinking juice go? Where is all the stuff that I need to function? I used it up. You haven't replaced it. My memory has been fantastic. Terrible. Terrible. I'm saying fantastic in the most sarcastic possible way. I don't want there to be any mistake about that. But yeah. Gardening and come back with the wood later. I want to get back to at least 2 streams a week and probably like a bonus stream over the weekend when I'm like working on a painting or something. The structure broke when I moved because I was just doing too much. I was still setting up and still getting the house together, but now that, I mean, each of the rooms that aren't perfect are like 20 minutes of cleaning away from being perfect and completely set up, and now the only issue we have is that we haven't been able to get the recycling guys to take any of the cardboard from when we moved. Still, they're definitely supposed to accept corrugated cardboard, but I don't think they like how it's bundled or the size of the boxes or something. So I'm gonna have to work on that. I don't want to use up all of my good twine on it because it's actually really expensive for whatever reason. So I need to find like some kind of natural cord that I can bind it with to get it outside. But yeah, might do a cheesecake again soon. Might cook again soon. I'd like to draw again soon. I had entire streams lined up with my sketchbook to do. I want to show you the lamps. Mostly, I should go and keep getting stuff set up. Because, yeah, one of the things I was going to say is that I'm still actually in the middle of cleaning the kitchen today and reorganizing everything because I had to set up all of my plants. Or at least the shelves that all of the plants are going to go on. I have like half of my crops in, and I had to rearrange everything like around this new setup, so that the kitchen isn't a crowded disaster. The dining room is even less of a crowded disaster than it was. My one roommate doesn't like the look of the shelf now that it's big and empty, but one of the shelves I put together, I'll take a picture of it later, is kind of necessary for once the seedlings stop quite being seedlings and the ground still isn't defrosted, which again isn't going to be until the 22nd of next month. The larger plants are going to need a place to go where they still have access to enough sunlight to keep them vibrant, we'll say, until I can get them outside. And I'm just really super excited about the yard this year. I do, in fact, have plants that, you know, don't do any damage with their roots and soak up a lot of water that I might like to plant around the foundation of the house that are, like, low maintenance and do well in the shade. And I do definitely have flowers that I would like to add to the flower boxes in the front. I definitely have a use for the shed and the garage, and I want to put my bird feeder inside of a large planter because I want to have bird feeders, and they said we could so long as like we clean up after them. I think I'd like to find places that I can put planters without hurting the grass, just like large round movable ones, and mostly hang the bird feeders on posts in those so that the spilling that they do on the lawn or any part of the yard that I would have to actually clean up is minimized. And then that way when the seeds fall, they can either grow there and make more bird seed effectively for the birds, or they can fall in with like other flowers and plants that I have planted there actually for the animals and not for us. So non-spicy greens for the deer and the rabbits. And I'm definitely excited to see the rabbits and the chipmunks and the birds a lot more. We have a pair of chickadees nesting near our front door. I put out like another little hanging bird nest today and a bird feeder full of seed. on one of the deck corners since it's still snowy. There's a lot that I've been like eager to fix up and to put together and to get done, that it's finally approaching the season where I can actually do that. So that's cool. So I don't know whether somebody's initializing the Hydra bot for me, but it's here and it's gone off, and I feel like my other bot should have gone off by now too. Oh cool, well I mean at least we can test the chat, but I don't know if I can actually get to my dashboard without closing the stream to try to... At least I know I'm online, because I had a couple of viewers. Y'all are gone right now, I think, if that's accurate, and that's fine. But I'd almost question if I wasn't actually streaming. I know, it was really last minute, and it got to be like past 6 when I said I'd stream. And I was really wishy-washy telling you guys that I was coming on today, but there is going to be a recording on YouTube. You can click through it long enough to see what I did with the bricks, if you want. The door. I swear I had everything set out here before I started. There it is. I'm actually in a lot of pain right now, but staying still doesn't help. So what I'd like to do is at least keep pretending to have energy long enough. Can you focus again? Just once more on the door. Yeah. I widened the hole enough that once all the stonework that needs to go in behind it on top of the wood is built up, this can like go on the very tip of this thing and be held on. I still want to sculpt the little like hinge bits for it that look like this, kind of more or less. And do the decals around the side of the door that'll make like the round post sticking out of it look like the eye, like I have here. And I need to find the right stones to do the other stonework around here. Sculpt the knobs, stuff like that. I'd kind of like to have it actually be hinged. And I do have small hinges for that. And actually open, but I also don't want to get rid of like the little post bit that's sticking out of it. So I might cut that off and glue it into the hole on the door. We'll see. Cause I might like there to be cracks of light that come out around the door. So if I don't cut this out entirely, I might just like cut in like the cracks along the edge in like key places, like up the front of here. So that you kind of maybe rough up or like notch the edges of the door, like the wood split a little bit just at the edge in a few places to give it a bit more character, and so you can like see the light coming through around the cracks in the door. The clock mechanism is nice and straightforward. I also have these gears that I located when I was working on this, that I think would work well for whatever the heck I had planned here. I was mapping out something with wheels. Gears, sorry. Can't tell you what. But yeah. Actually, you know what I'm gonna do with this? This little hexagonal tile. Oh, that's pretty. Yeah. What we're gonna do with this is I'm gonna make one mold for it once it's all evened out. make a whole bunch of copies of them. And then carve like a unique design into each one of a few, right? And then mold those individual unique ones and make a bunch of molds to fill up with the slip, which I will rehydrate when I'm actually gonna use it. I don't wanna leave it hydrated because I don't want it to get moldy. So it's got this really cool sort of cracked texture. Starting to think that this is not focusing just because I can't hold still. That's a nifty texture. I like that. I took pictures of that for reference. But yeah, I don't want it to get moldy, which it will if I don't use it. But I need my tree smaller and less obtrusive. It's sitting on my bar the way it should be. Got all of that sorted out. I might have gotten off track, but what I meant to express was that I'm hoping that within the next day, I actually will have the energy to finish cleaning up and doing all of the details, including preparing the table out there for a vlog and the table in here for a vlog, and I mean cleaning up my desk for the next one and cutting a bunch of wood and getting together some materials and references so that we can have like a very good solid like months worth of streams for crafting without anything going wrong or any kind of interruptions. And if I can get a hold of the right kind of baking dish, I'd like to revisit that cheesecake that I make with you guys, so you can see how nicely it comes out in appropriately sized pans, and so that we can do something extra fancy with it. There's a sort of cake I've been designing in my head that involves a lot of cheesecake that's really fancy and very elaborate that I might like to put together with you guys on stream. And I would certainly like to eat it right now. I've just been eating avocados, just like the millennial I am, just shoveling them in my face. You know, which is great. I'm sure my body is making use of the fats right now. But yeah, I need to go shovel in more avocado and get stuff together for next time. So, and also figure out why my chatbots aren't working, other than the Hydra bot. So, I will see you guys later. Thank you for joining me. I will be uploading this to YouTube, and if you check out my Instagram, you'll see in progress pictures of stuff I'm doing around the house, including stuff for the streams. And if you go over to Twitter, you will get invited to my Discord server so you can chat with all of us when I'm like offline, off stream anyway, and be updated on Twitter about when I'm going to stream ahead of time, hopefully. I always forget to plug that stuff, which is what I need the bot for. I'm sorry. I did make a robot so that this stuff would. A robot. I made a whole robot, a physical robot, not like keyed in details for a pre-made algorithm. I just, yeah. I tried to set it up so that it would just once an hour, if like it had gone off the screen somewhere, it would be like, hey, here's my social media. So that I wouldn't have to worry about it because I never do. I never remember, and I can't ask me to remember. So, oh look, it's a kitty. We're saying the long goodbye. This is how we say goodbye in my family, and it's like an entire trope. We say, I'm leaving now, and then we like chat in the doorway for like an hour, like literally an hour. Sometimes two. It's talent. Hey, baby. You know what? You can see my clean laundry pile that I threw on the end of my bed. Hey, BB. Yeah, you're a very good boy. You're gonna get fur all over my clean laundry. Yeah, you enjoy that. Oh, look at the fluffy butt. That's all we get to see. Oh, there we go. Hey, BB. He wants to be fed again. I know he does. He's a sweet boy. I can't remember, so I'm going to have an algorithm remember for me, which is why you're always hearing alarms go off on my phone. I have no short-term memory, so I just set alarms for everything. And then a computer acts as my short-term processing and memory. It's just like, hey, so you don't forget you had something in the oven. Hey, you were doing laundry and you probably need to change the load now. Just alarm for everything. It's like I've just delegated that processing to computers because I obviously can't manage it myself. Hey, BB. Oh, you're such a sweet boy. You don't want to come up here? We'll just look at pumpkin while mommy says goodbye for 2 hours. Yeah. But I do have to go. I have to feed Munchkin here. Pumpkin. His name is Pumpkin. Yeah. He's a good boy. But yeah, I'll go do that. And set up the other work surface. And dear Lord, this desk is not supposed to be the desk where all this is happening. All this crafting is supposed to be being done in the desk in the laundry room, which is only there until it can be in the shed or in the garage. And that's not accessible because I'm still like slowly getting through the laundry that built up being in the last place that would flood every time I tried to wash clothing. So still working on that slowly, trying not to drive up like a huge water bill. Hi. Yeah, no, I I see you. I do. You're gonna be super cute for the camera. What if I ignore you more? You're gonna attack me in front of the whole internet. You're gonna slap me in the face. Bite my hair. He likes to bite my hair. He doesn't want to bite my face, but he'll like try to bite the top of my head and then like just sort of yank at my hair. Like a dick. But yeah. I'm being poked. I need to go do that. I need to leave. I need to come back with many exciting things. I'm gonna make a checklist and then actually follow it and check it next time. And I will see you then. If I can remember which button. Oh, I never do this. I just need to do this. When I get to the AFK screen, when I come on, I just need to click that off first, so when I go AFK, it doesn't just still have the message there. Like, what if I need to take a break? It just confuses everyone every time. I'm so sorry. God damn it.